During this video, we give a brief illustrative example of the adaptive protection related to the grid-connected mode of a microgrid. The main learning objectives will fall under two questions. Firstly, how will the adaptive protection work during the grid-connected mode? Secondly, how will the adaptive protection help avoid the selectivity issues in microgrids? Now let's have a look into one example of a microgrid which is connected to the external grid. In this example, we assume that the distributed generator is not present in switchboard 1. Moreover, the end of the feeders above and below are not connected. In other words, switchboard 2 and switchboard 4 are not connected. If a fault occurs between switchboard 1 and switchboard 2, then the fault current is supplied from the grid. For this case, the fault current will pass through circuit breaker 1.2. Then circuit breaker 2.1 will be open using a follow me function of CP1.12. Note that this function helps disconnect both the head and the end of each line as soon as one of the two relays detects the fault. Once these two circuit breakers 1.2 and 2.1 will be open, switchboard 2 becomes disconnected from the grid. To increase the reliability and reduce the time period of the disconnection of switchboard 2, it can be then connected to the grid through another path. Circuit breakers 2.2 and 4.2 are closed, and therefore switchboard 2 is connected to switchboard 4. This way, it is ensured that switchboard 2 will have the supply of the electricity as soon as possible after the fault. Now let's assume that the second fault occurs inside switchboard 2. In this case, the fault current is provided again through the external grid. But unlike the previous example, in this case, the fault current is supplied by the feeder below. In this case, the fault current will be from the right-hand side to the left-hand side direction. Typically, if the directional relays are used, then the setting of the tripping time will be obviously different in various directions. The fault current direction from left to right or from right to left. In this figure, we show an example of the typical time settings of the directional relays for the first case where switchboards 2 and 4 were disconnected. If the direction of the fault current in the grid would be from left to right, then the tripping time settings of the relays will be reduced from the head of the feeder at circuit breaker 1 to the end of the feeder at circuit breaker 2.2. For instance, this means that if a fault occurs at the end of the feeder, then circuit breaker 2.2 will disconnect first after 0.07 seconds. If circuit breaker 2.2 fails to disconnect, then circuit breaker 1.2 will disconnect within 0.12 seconds. On the opposite direction, when the fault current direction is from right to left, then the time settings will reduce from the end of the feeder at circuit breaker 2.2 to the head of the feeder at circuit breaker 2. During the first fault, the configuration of the grid was changed in such a way that switchboard 2 was connected to switchboard 4. However, the typical time setting of relays was designed for the first example, where the time setting of switchboard 2 for the fault current from right to left is 0.25 seconds. This value is relatively large, as circuit breaker 2.2 shall be disconnected faster. If circuit breaker 4.2 does not trip, then in this example, circuit breaker 4.1 will trip within 0.12 seconds, which is faster than circuit breaker 2.2. As a result, switchboard 4 is inappropriately disconnected from the grid. To solve this selectivity issue, we employ the adaptive protection. The main reason to use the adaptive protection is that in this case, the configuration of the microgrid has been completely changed after the first fault. Therefore, all the relay's time current tripping settings shall be adapted to the new configuration. Therefore, For this example, the time setting of circuit breaker 2.2 is changed from 0.25 to 0.07 seconds. Therefore, if circuit breaker 4.2 does not disconnect, then circuit breaker 2.2 will be disconnected faster than circuit breaker 4.1 to avoid the unnecessary disconnection of switchboard 4. In this video, we discussed an example of the adaptive protection for a microgrid in the grid-connected mode. We showed that once the configuration of the network changes, then the selectivity problem may occur. To avoid this, the time settings of the relays is adjusted using the adaptive protection.